Thank you. everyone. Welcome to the Athenaeum, and thank you so much for being with us this evening. My name is Veronica Zales, and I'm the director here. I would like to give a big shout out and thank you to everybody at Jane Franklin Dance for bringing tonight's unique performance to us. And we are thrilled to be partnering with Jane Franklin Dance to bring live performances to you here at the Athenaeum. Bits and Pieces features visual arts and dance collaborations with visual artist Oenone Hammersley and Darren Smith, and their artworks are around us. Right now, they're the featured artists at the Athenaeum, and their artworks will be on display through March 6th. On March 6th, there will also be an artist talk and meet and greet at 2 p.m., so if you're in the area, please stop by. All works are for sale, so if you're interested in learning more about any of the artwork, or if you would like to make a purchase, please let me know. The tonight's performance will include new works inspired by Oenone and Darren, alongside recent repertory about attraction and partnership. During the course of the performance, Jane is going to ask everybody in the audience to get up and move to this area over here. We'll wait for Jane to give us that cue, and then move on to the next performance. And so now I would like to turn it over to Jane to begin tonight's performance. And again, thank you, Jane Franklin Dance, and everybody at Jane Franklin Dance for bringing us dance this evening.
Laughing at the real. Where? pour Paris. La température actuelle est parfaite. Il s'arrêtera de pleuvoir d'une minute à l'autre et le soleil sortira. Tous à bord. Attention à la marche en descendant du train.
Direction Porte d'Orléans. Prochain train dans une minute. Le suivant dans 5 minutes.
Frappe à ma porte, me parle des amours mortes devant le feu qui s'éteint. Ce soir, c'est une chanson d'automne dans la maison qui frissonne et je pense aux jours lointains. Que reste-t-il de nos amours? Que reste-t-il de ces beaux jours? Une photo, vieille photo de ma jeunesse. Que reste-t-il des billets doux, des mois d'avril, des rendez-vous, un souvenir qui me poursuit sans cesse. Bonheur fané, cheveux au vent, baisers volés, rêve mouvant, que reste-t-il de tout cela? Dites-le-moi. Un petit village, un vieux clocher, un paysage si bien caché, et dans un nuage, le cher visage de mon passé. Les mots tendres qu'on murmure, les caresses les plus pures, les serments au fond des bois, les fleurs qu'on retrouve dans un livre, dont le parfum vous enivre, se sont envolées. Pourquoi? Que reste-t-il de nos amours? Que reste-t-il de ces beaux jours? Une photo, vieille photo de ma jeunesse. Que reste-t-il des billets doux, des mois d'avril, des rendez-vous, un souvenir qui me poursuit sans cesse. Bonheur fané, cheveux au vent, baisers volés, rêves mouvants, que reste-t-il de tout cela? Dites-le-moi. Un petit village, un vieux clocher, un paysage si bien caché, et dans un nuage, le cher visage de mon passé, de mon passé.
The paint pouring. Got these wooden panels which are cut in the shape of water. I just moved to using wood because I wanted to get that feeling of flowing that you can't get so much in the box shape of a canvas. Little windows in the waves to get this effect of shiny mirrors behind. It enhances the water, I think. I've also got glass beads which have been collaged on, and then I put resin on top, which gives a very lustrous finish. The canvas pieces are much larger. Hand painting in the middle and then paint pouring around the edges. Do small pours where I blow the paint around the canvas. It's quite difficult controlling the paint. You have to manipulate the canvas and then hope that it doesn't go over the hand poured bit, which it usually does, and I have to then repaint it. So it's quite difficult to get that exactly how you want. Feeling, which is so much more evocative in a way than the hand-painted ones. I'm really pleased with the way they've come out. Two different methods I use for pouring the paint. One where you drag across the paint, where you use oil in with the paint, and then you get sort of little cells, they call little bubbles. The other way, where you're just manipulating the canvas or the wooden panel and the water just flows around. The cells sort of pop out more when you use a blowtorch. And I can't say that I have total control over what the paint's going to do. I'd have a vague idea, and it's very interesting. I did the last few what are called ring pours. They are where the paint is put in a cup all on top of each other in different layers, and then you pour it together and you get these rings which look a bit like a geode. And it's interesting how different they turn out, even if you use the same colours and in different orders. It just, every single time, they come out differently. whole point was to talk about our use of water, and was at the time when South Africans were all lining up for a bucket of water, and we don't realize how lucky we are just having water flowing freely out of the taps, you know. And I've heard of people who have showers with buckets around them to catch as much water as they possibly can, and then they take it outside and put it on the garden, you know, to water the garden. And you can't really imagine many Americans doing that, can you?
Sunshine, and when we kiss, your side, where fields of flowers bloom in the sunshine.
If there was anyone I'd want to spend about 100 days with, laying in the yard, staring up at stars, wondering where all the planes went, it would be you.
I've always had a surreal sensibility from a young age. I was drawn especially to M.C. Escher and Salvador Dali and other surrealists. And I wanted to find a way that I could bring surrealism to photography. I wanted to kind of create surreal visions, but I was unable to photograph them. So I realized with the collage technique that I could just cut up, just with scissors and glue, I could kind of create these surreal visions that I had in my mind with my photographs. I had never been interested in digital manipulation. I wanted to do something handcrafted, just using just the power of the hand to kind of create the surreal visions that I had in my head. I'm out in the world and I see something visually intriguing, then I shoot a ton of photos, but I don't know what the subject is going to be. And then I make a lot of prints, and how the ideas come about is a very physical process where I'm pushing around prints on my tabletop until I see combinations coming together. It's a very tactile process, one that involves touching the photos and then cutting them up and putting them back together again. I think, yeah, a number of them are symmetrical, and I think my work is primarily optimistic. I'm hoping that the viewer can stop for a moment and maybe see something in a different way, because I've presented maybe something that was familiar, but in an unusual context. Notions of symmetry, I think it's what the human eye often finds pleasing. Yeah, that's the National Cathedral here in DC. They had an event and the cathedral was projecting light inside of the cathedral, and it was changing all different colors. And it was wonderful for me because I walked around and I could just station myself at different spots and just keep taking photos, and the light would keep changing. And so it gave me a lot of material to work with. Done a whole series of faces and eyes. The faces actually started out of this idea of seeing ourselves in nature, that we think of ourselves as so human beings, as so separate from nature, that we're above it, that we're not a part of the animal world. So my goal was, if I made portraits out of nature, where our faces, human faces, were actually composed of natural subjects, that then perhaps we would see ourselves more as being part of nature rather than apart from it.
So much. I just wanted to acknowledge our choreographers here, Andie, deVaulx. Who choreographed the piece for 40 plus? Yes, yes. Our 40 plus performers, you can just stand up right where you are. Most of them are standing. And Philip, here, and we happen to have both the visual artists here with us today, Darren Smith and Oenone Hammersley here. So we want to extend our sincere thanks to the Athenaeum and especially to Executive Director Veronica Zales, who does so much work in presenting. It's always a delight to be here at the Athenaeum and to also work with these incredible visual artists that the Athenaeum brings to bear. So thank you so much for joining us today. And Veronica has something to say.
So can we just say a couple of things about the artwork and how it inspired movement from the, you know, for the two dancers with Oenone and with Darren?
For Oenone's work and for Darren's, we didn't single out any one particular piece, but sort of use their whole their ideas in a real overall concept way. For Darren's, I liked what when we talked, he talked a lot about symmetry and also little fragments and just the juxtaposition of different angles as he cuts the little pieces to assemble them together. So I kind of tried to do that with the with the dance, using not everybody standing in the same facing, but a lot of different facings and angles. And then with Nonet's, we use definitely the water imagery a lot, and the idea of pouring one thing on top of the other. So those were, that's where how we worked with those sort of in an overall concept way.
It's always fascinating to hear with the process with both of the artists and the dancers.
And just like most of the pieces I do, I come in with a certain amount of set material, but then we always add to that some improvisation. The dancers also add maybe some movement ideas that they stumble upon, and I say, let's add that. Or it's, so it's always a very collaborative way of working together. And I'm very fortunate to have these wonderful folks work with me. So. We have two shows coming up in March. One of them is here, though. It's not here. It's at the Intersections Festival in Washington, D.C. at the Atlas Performing Arts Center. I have a card up there on the table, so please grab that. And we're also doing a show in Richmond on March 12th. I know not probably anyone here is from Richmond, but if you know of anyone in Richmond, please tell us about our show there. And we'd love to have you come see the show there. That show does not feature Darren or Nonet's work, but the previous collaboration we did here at the Athenaeum, it features the work of those five visual artists, sort of translated through some video animation by Neitz and Scharf, who I worked with so we have a backdrop and could carry the artwork with us. So please come see us again. If you can't make it then, maybe some other time when we're back here at the Athenaeum.
And don't forget, March 6th at 2:00, we have an artist talk with Moni and Darren. Join us on March 6th at 2:00 for an artist talk and meet and greet with Darren and Noni. And it starts at 2:00, and I'll go from 2 to 4.
Thank you all so much also for, we were live streaming the show today. Hopefully it worked out okay. We had a good stream, so. Thank you for your patience in dealing with all the extension cord and so on and so forth. Greatly appreciate your flexibility. All right, thanks so much. Have a great day.
I didn't know if you had a QA.